Hello, my name is Steve Carpenter. We're bringing you Christmas greetings from our house to your house and all our little stuffed animal friends on the floor. I'm going to play for you a number of nursery rhyme stories that I done all the recording, all the voices myself. I hope you will enjoy them.
Once upon a time, there were three little pigs. And this is another story from the Story Man. And the three little pigs lived in a forest with their mother. So one day, the mother said to the three little pigs,
"You are all grown now, and you must go out and find a house of your own."
And the three little pigs began to argue. Then the three little pigs said,
"Okay, Mom. Anyway, we'll go out and we'll find something to build a house of our own."
So they slept through the night. When the morning arrived, the three little pigs got up and each of them left out of the house in their own direction, looking for something to build a house of their own. And the first little pig came upon some straw. And he said to himself,
All this straw, there are pounds and pounds and pounds of straw. I know what I'll do. I'll take that straw and I'll build me a big straw house."
And he took the straw and he labored all day and he labored all night. And by the next morning, he had finished his house of straw. And he went inside and he said,
"This is all mine. I love my straw house. It is all mine. Oh, I love it so much."
In the meantime, the second little pig had wandered through the forest for a few days, hadn't found anything. But all of a sudden, his eyes came upon a big pile of wood. And I mean, it was a lot of wood. And he said to himself,
"All this wood. There's enough wood for me to build me a wood house."
And he got the wood and he began to labor through the day and labor through the night. And then the next day came. And by the middle of the next day, he had finished building his house of wood. And he went inside and said,
"Oh my, I love this wood house. This house is all mine. And I love it very much."
And he went inside and closed his door. And began looking at his house and enjoying what he saw that he had done with his own hands. In the meantime, the third little pig had wandered from one day to the next day to the next day, becoming discouraged, not finding anything to build a house of his own. And he said to himself, and all of a sudden he looked around and there was all these bricks. I mean, tons and tons and tons of brick. And his eyes lit up like stars. And he said to himself,
"I'll take these bricks and I'll build me the strongest house in the world out of bricks."
And he labored through the day and he labored through the night, but he was not finished. And he took a rest. Then he labored through the rest of the day and the rest of the night. And by the next day, he had finished his big, strong house of bricks. And he saw a kettle outside. And he put the kettle in the house and he put some wood under it and lit a fire. And he said, he put it up under the chimney. And he said,
"I'll keep this kettle because I can cook something in it."
In the meantime, he went in his house and he began enjoying it. But in the woods, there was a predator. There was somebody very dangerous that loved to eat little pigs. And that was the big, bad wolf. And a wolf was walking through the forest, and he saw this straw house, and he said,
"What is that? I never saw that before. Let me check it out."
And he walked up to the door, and he knocked on the door, and he said,
"Let me in! Let me in!"
And the little pig looked out the window of the straw house, and he said,
"Mommy, chair, here are my chin, chin, chin."
And he said, "Well, I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow you out of sin." And he huffed, and he puffed, and he blew the little pig's house in the straw, and the little pig went running,
Oh my God!
And he was running, he was out of breath. He was headed to the wolf, and he got to his brother's house, and he knocked on the door.
"Brother! Brother! Let me in, let me out! The wolf is after me, the wolf is after me!"
And his brother opened the door, and his brother slammed the door.
"Oh, the wolf is after me! He just blew my house down a straw! And now, he's coming, he's at your door! What are we gonna do?"
And his brother said, "My house is built of wood. He can't get in here." And the wolf came to the door all tired, and he knocked. "Let me in." And he knocked again. "Let me in." And the two little pigs said,
"Let me hear my chin, chin, chin."
He said, "Well, I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in." And he huff, and he puff, and he blew the house in. And the two little pigs were running,
oh my God, he blew out all things too, he blew out all things too. Now my brother, I'm here, run.
And the brother felt, and the other pig went and picked him up, and he said, "Come on, brother, we got to go. And they got to the third little pig's house that was built to brick.
"Brother, not a thing."
They knocked.
The wolf is after us.
And his brother opened the door, and he slammed the door. And the brother's house is door said,
"The wolf came to my house and he blew my house in. And he was trying to chase me and trying to eat me. And I came to my other brother's house, which was built of wood.
And the one's house is built of wood."
"Yeah. And he came and he blew my house in town. I don't know where he's going to stay with that house. And now he's at your door. What are we going to do?"
And the third brother said, "Have no fear. I labored through the day. I labored through the night, and I labored through the next day and through the next night, and I built me a strong house of bricks. How do you think the wolf is going to come in here? He can huff and he can puff all he wants to, but he can't blow this house in. So here comes the wolf, and he knocks on the door, and he says,
'I am tired of this. Let me in.'"
And the three little pigs said,
"Not only here, but chin, chin, chin."
He said, "Well, I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in." And he huffed, and he puffed, but he could not blow the house in. And the wolf was mad.
I'm tired of this.
And he climbed through the roof, and he seen the chimney.
Don't run, whatever you do.
And he said, "I'll go down this chimney." But remember, the third brother's house was built of bricks, and he found the kettle, and he lit a fire with water in it over the chimney. Under the chimney. And the wolf went down the chimney, and he fell into the hot water, and then he said, go, and he opened the door, and they ran, and the wolf ran away, and they never saw that wolf again. That is the story from the story, man. And until next time,
whatever you want to do, or leave it like it is,
ladies and gentlemen,
and do your work, because it's going to be
plain. Hello, boys and girls. I guess you know who this is by now. It's someone
every once in a while I gotta
that has in storage stories from when I was a child that was told to me. And them stories that I haven't stored, I'm going to play them on this tape for you from my tape. And I want you to enjoy them. Now, once upon a time, there was this girl, and her name was Goldilocks. and she lived in the woods. And one day she was walking through the woods, just looking around, picking flowers and having a good time. In the meantime, there was a house in the wood that belonged to three bears. There was a papa bear, there was a mama bear, and there was a
little baby bear.
And one day, the mama bear cooked some porridge for the family to eat. But when she put the porridge in the big bowl for the father, in the middle bowl for herself, and a little teeny bowl for the baby bear, the papa bear sat down in his big chair, and the mother bear sat down in her medium-sized chair, and the baby bear sat down in the little teeny, teeny chair. And they all taste the porridge.
Ah, it's too hot.
The baby bear said. The mama bear said, mine's just too hot too. And then the papa bear said, mine's is very hot. So then the papa bear suggested, I'll tell you what. Let's take a walk. And when we come back, the porridge will be cool. I'll be able to eat it. So they left out the door and slammed the door. And they went out into the forest to take a walk and to enjoy themselves. In the meantime, this girl named Goldilocks was walking through the forest. And she saw the house. And she said to herself,
oh, that's such a beautiful little house. I think I'll go in and see what it's about. I never saw that house here before. Maybe there's neighbors and I can talk to them.
So she went up to the door and she knocked on the door.
Hello? Hello? My name is Goldilocks. Can I come in?
And nobody said anything. Then she knocked on the door again. And the door opened. And she looked inside and she said,
hello?
And nobody answered. Then she walked inside. And she saw this great big chair. Then she saw this medium-sized chair. Then she saw this little teeny baby chair. And she looked around and she saw this great big bed. Then she saw this medium-sized bed. Then she saw this little teeny teeny bed. And she smelled something. She said,
I smell something. It smells good.
And she walked to the table and she seen this great big bowl of porridge. And then she walked to a medium-sized chair and she seen a middle-sized of porridge. And she went to the baby bear's bed, a baby bear's chair, and she seen a small bowl of porridge next to the small chair. And she tasted the big bowl of porridge and she said,
it's too hot.
Then she tasted the medium-sized bowl of porridge, and she said,
it's also too hot.
But then she went to the little teeny bowl, which didn't have much porridge in it, and she tasted it, and it was cool, and she said,
this is just right.
And she ate all the porridge. Then she started to yawn.
Oh, I'm so tired.
And she looked around, and she seen this great big bed. And she said to herself,
this bed is too big, and it's hard.
Then she went to the middle-sized bed, which was the mother bear's bed, and she said,
this bed is just too soft. I can't sleep on this.
Then she went to the baby bear's bed, and she said,
I like this bed. It's small, just my size.
And she wanted to take a little nap. She didn't intend to go to sleep. And she laid down, she took a nap. She started snoring. In the meantime, the papa bear said to the mother bear and the baby bear, let's go home and eat our porridge. And they went to the house, and they knew they had closed the door, but the door was open. And the papa bear walked in, the mother bear walked in, the baby bear walked in. And the first thing the papa bear noticed that his chair had been moved, his big chair, and he said, somebody's been sitting in my chair. And the mother bear noticed that her chair had been good news. She said, somebody's been sitting in my chair. And the baby bear noticed that his chair was all broken up. He said, somebody's been sitting in my chair and broke it all up. Then the papa bear looked at his big bowl of porridge and he seen a little spoonful gone. He said, somebody has been tasting my porridge. And the mother bear looked at her medium-sized bowl of porridge. She said, and I see
somebody has been tasting my porridge.
And then the baby bear said,
somebody has been tasting my porridge. And it ain't all up.
And then he looked around. And the papa bear saw his bed was wrinkled. And he said, somebody has been lying in my bed. And then the mother bear said,
my bed is wrinkled. Somebody has been lying in my bed also.
And then the baby bear said,
somebody has been lying in my bed, and here they are.
And then they began to say,
who's this? Who's this? Who's this?
In the meantime, Goldilocks woke up.
Oh my gosh, what am I doing? Where am I?
And she ran up the door and ran down through the forest, and they never saw Goldilocks again. And that is the story of Goldilocks and the three bears. Till the next time that the story man will bring you a story.
Creaked on all four pillars. And he passed Little Red Riding Hood. And Little Red Riding Hood said, oh, get off of me! Get off of me! Leave me alone, Big Wolf! I'm going to my grandmother's house. I have some rolls in here. And the wolf said, I know. And they smell good. And I'm going to take them and tie it to this tree. So he tied it to the tree. And he took her hood off her head and put it on his own head. And he went to the grandmother's house and he knocked on the door. Grandmother said,
who is it?
And the wolf said, it's the Red
Riding Hood.
And he changed his voice. And the grandmother said,
well, come in, come in, come in.
And the wolf came in and he closed the door. And the grandmother said,
what big eyes you have.
And the wolf said, the better to see you with, my dear. Then the grandmother said to the wolf,
oh, what big ears you have.
And the wolf said, the better to hear you with, my dear. Then the grandmother said, and he said, they're ready to eat you with my dinner. And the grandmother went running out of the house.
She never ran so fast. She left her walker. She left everything. And she ran until she got to the house of her daughter. And I don't know, somehow they got Little Red Riding Hood untied. And they all got to the house. And they locked that wolf out. And then somehow the wolf just disappeared, eating the rolls.
And you know what? They never saw that wolf again. And that is the story of Little Red Riding Hood. Until the next time that you receive a story from the Story Man.
Boys and girls, another story from the Story Man. Once upon a time, there was this woodcarver, and all of his life he carved wood, making planes, making trains, making all forms of objects. He was very creative with what he'd done. He was an artist in his own forms. But he was a lonely man. He made toys for children, and he gave them to them. But he had always wanted a child of his own, but he never had one. So one day, he said to himself, I'm going to make me a little boy of wood. So he began carving, making arms, making legs, making the head, making the body, and he put them all together. And he had a little boy that he had strings tied to like a puppet.
Hello.
So he named the boy Pinocchio. And Pinocchio had a pointy little nose. And he used to walk around the shop playing with Pinocchio with the string that if he was real. So one day he wished that he had a real little boy. And one night, something mystical happened. Very mystical. And the mystery is still being told how Pinocchio became alive. And when Pinocchio became alive, he began playing with the other children that lived around in the neighborhood. But Pinocchio was still made of wood. And the other kids were made of flesh and blood and bones. And Pinocchio recognized something different of himself. And one day he returned to his father and he said, Dad, why am I different from them?
This is getting soft. And mine is hard.
He said, "Don't worry, Pinocchio. You're my son." And then one night, his dad began praying to Carver. And he said,
I wish Pinocchio would have flesh like the other children and be able to play like them and not feel different."
And the next morning when Pinocchio got up and his dad was sleeping, he ran into his dad's room and he said,
"Dad! Dad, look at me! I'm real! I'm real! I'm a real little boy!"
And his father said, "Oh my gosh!" He got up out of the bed. He began feeling Pinocchio's arms and he said, "Oh my God, you are real!" He gave a great big hug and a kiss. "Oh my God, thank you, thank you, thank you! You're real!" And he let Pinocchio go and play with the other kids. The other kids recognized that he was as they are. But there was one problem. And that problem was that Pinocchio could not tell a lie. Because every time he would tell a lie, his nose would grow. And his father said to him one day, "Pinocchio, were you playing good with the children out there?" And the Pinocchio said,
"Yeah, Dad. Why do you ask me that?"
"Because I saw you throw that ball into the water, Pinocchio, and start laughing. That is not playing good." And Pinocchio said,
"It wasn't me. It wasn't me."
And his nose began to grow. And his father looked,
"Oh, what happened to
him?" He said, "Well, don't do it again." Pinocchio went in his room angry and looked in the mirror at his nose.
"Why is my nose grown like that?"
The next day his nose was the same size. And then he said to his dad,
"I'll never tell a lie again."
And he went out and he began playing with the kids again. And the next thing you know, Pinocchio had mischief on his mind again. And he started running with the ball by himself and all the kids.
"Pinocchio, we have to play together. Stop taking the ball for yourself. You have to learn how to share. And you gotta be good. And you gotta stop telling lies. Because we heard that you said that you did kick that ball. And then in the water, you know you did. We like you, but you gotta stop telling lies. Otherwise, we're not gonna play with you anymore."
And so, Pinocchio's father was looking out the window. And when Pinocchio went in, his dad asked him, "Did you hog the ball to yourself, or did you share the ball with the other kids?"
"Dad, I told you I wouldn't do anything bad again."
And his nose began to grow and grow and grow and grow. And his father said,
"I know what it is. He can't tell a lie, and that's why his nose is growing."
And his father said, "Pinocchio,
not
you
turn
see,
your camera off by turning.
You became a real boy.
Not turn it off.
But there's one
not
thing you can't do.
Make it turn off.
You can't tell a lie or your nose will begin to grow and keep growing.
Wow.
So I advise you, because you have been able to turn into a real boy, to never lie again. Because it is not good to lie, and it's always good to play with your friends and cheer." So the next day, Pinocchio went out and he played with the kids and he was good.
You got it right? Okay.
And he came home and his father said, "Pinocchio, were you bad today?" And Pinocchio said, "No." And his father said, "I know, because I was watching you." And his nose turned back to regular size. And he was a real boy and he never lied again. And his nose never grew again. And that is the story of Pinocchio. So I'm telling you, all you boys and girls, and you fathers and mothers, don't lie to your children, and children, don't lie to your parents, because your parents are just a peer that are rent you.
Just tap the red.
They're a peer, parents that rent you, but you belong to God through the Holy Spirit and our Lord Jesus Christ. So remember that. This is a story from the story man. Now be good to each other. Bye.
Once upon a time, another story from the story man. So ask your parents to get you a little bit of refreshments, a little juice, a little milk. And you sit down and you relax with your parents, your father and your mother, your aunts and your uncles, your family and your friends. And listen to this story. Because this story, I want you to import so you can have support. So when you begin to transport, you will have a foundation. Now, in simple language, children, listen to the story. Once upon a time, there was this little boy. And he always liked to lie, get people to believe his lies. And he would sit up under a mountain, and he would always say,
"Oh, Mom, Dad, the wolf is after me. They're coming to get me, they're coming to get me."
And they would all run up the hill to see if the wolf was after them. When they got up the hill, they was out of breath. And he'd lie on the ground like, and then father and mother said, "You need to stop doing that. You need to stop doing that. Don't do it anymore."